Today I'm going to talk about the mark of the beast. I mentioned it before when I was sharing last time in my last video. I mentioned it in passing when I was talking about the Great Tribulation. So today I just focus on the mark of the beast. So I'll begin by reading from Revelations chapter 13, verses 16 to 17. It says, "And he causeth, he is the beast, or the Antichrist, or the man of sin. And he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name." Here is wisdom. I read verse 18 as well. "Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. So this is the number 666. So, yeah, last time I was talking about this mark of the beast, and that people will not be allowed to buy or sell without the mark of the beast. So it's for everyone. It says small, which means children, great, big people, rich people, poor people, free people, slaves, everyone will get this mark. Or at least will not be allowed to buy or sell unless they have this mark. So, at the same time that this mark is associated with commerce, the Bible says in Revelations chapter 14, we are given a warning that we should not accept this mark. So, Revelations chapter 14, I will read verses 9 to 13. It says, "And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, If any man worship the beast, and his image, and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever, and they have no rest day nor night, who worship the beast and his image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. Here is the patience of the saints, here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, Write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them." So the Bible clearly warns us that anyone who worships the beast, or accepts the mark of the beast, or worships the image of the beast, then they will face eternal damnation. That is what the Bible tells us here. So, last time I was saying, what can this be? So, obviously, this mark of the beast, no one is going to say, here, I have the mark of the beast, line up here, I'm going to give it to you. Definitely, it won't be like that. But we know that whatever thing that needs to be put into people, we have been seeing the microchips, and some people getting it. I know in Sweden, there have been articles on that, that people use these microchips to open doors and maybe to operate the printer, because now we use access cards, we have our debit cards, our credit cards to do transactions, and access cards like for opening doors, you can have that. So instead of you having the access card, then you will be having this microchip which can be injected into your hand. And for many years I thought, oh, this is very, very much like the kind of the technology the beast is going to use. But of late, I have come to change my mind on this, that it could well be that there will be a microchip. But you see, this microchip, it can be removed. So you can get it today and decide, I don't want to have this anymore. And then you go and they cut an incision and take it out. So, but now we have better candidates for the Mark of the Beast, because now we have nanotechnology, which when it goes in, I don't know how you there is no way to get it out. So you can change your mind. So I believe that this Mark of the Beast has to be something that is going to be permanent, that once you get it, no reverse. And I did talk about the issue of transhumanism, that for a long time I thought this transhumanism is definitely something that is going to be tied in with the Mark of the Beast. So how did I know that? It was just, I think it was inspiration of the Holy Spirit. Because I remember reading about what happens. We will cover what happens to the people who receive the Mark of the Beast, because it's important for people to understand that receiving the Mark of the Beast does not mean your life will go well. I mean, you might see it as a solution, but it is definitely not a solution. It will be a temporary solution, and it's not even a solution. It's just a temporary reprieve, I would say. Because you have immediate problem that you can't buy, you can't sell, if you don't get the Mark of the Beast. And at the same time, you might see it as a way out, that, oh, you know, I just get my mark and then my life goes on as normal. But your life will not be normal after you get this Mark of the Beast. And another thing is that this transhumanism, like once people embrace transhumanism, what's going to happen to them? And because you have to merge with this technology, you know, merging with the machine, what is going to happen to people? It's something to do with this Mark of the Beast, that I believe that when you get the Mark of the Beast, then you will be part of this. You will not be human anymore. You will be a transhuman. You will be something else. And this is partly why I believe you are rejected of God, because you're no longer in the image of God, the way God created you, but you have now become something else. So now, it's been burning in my heart to share about the Mark of the Beast, because we do have a candidate. We do have a contending candidate, because I believe a lot of people realize what is happening with this COVID-19 situation is not normal. Yeah, the measures, they are a bit crazy, and the figures don't speak to the situation. Yeah. Like, I was wondering, why are we getting numbers of cases, you know? Numbers of cases, as far as I'm concerned, don't mean much. And then these numbers of cases are cumulative. That means the people who have recovered from this COVID-19, who recovered long ago, maybe back in March, they are still being counted as cases today, you know, to keep the graph going. So some of these things, then Then, of course, we have the. I was watching a video about this Chinese virologist who was talking about the fact that this COVID-19 was created in the lab. It was engineered in the lab. So we know this situation is not normal. This situation is not natural either. This situation seems to be by design to bring on the vaccines. Because I don't understand why people would fight against a drug like hydroxychloroquine, and why would people fight if it works, or even if it works, if it's not so significant, but at least if it does something to improve someone's lot, why would you not give it a chance? And at the same time, this not promoting like nutrition and supplements to help people's health, to encourage people to take their vitamins, the vitamin D, the vitamin C, the nutrition way, the zinc that we are being told can also help. These things are not being promoted. We are just being told, nothing will be normal until we get the vaccines. But with so many other issues that vaccines do have, then you wonder, it must be some plot. Because how else can you explain this whole situation? Because obviously, all this misinformation is pretty much deliberate on the part of the authorities. So you can see there's an agenda at play. So it does not surprise me if these new vaccines have something to do with the mark of the beast. It does not surprise me at all. It is just my opinion. It's lots of speculation on my part, seeing what is unfolding. And there's someone who also is a believer with the Holy Spirit inside them. You see things that probably the normal person would not see, the other person would not see. You see, you connect the dots where other people are not connecting the dots. By God's grace, God reveals some of these things to you. So we do have this situation, and people need to watch out. And then another thing is, I've heard two doctors, I've heard two doctors, very courageous women, talking about the fact that these proposed vaccines are not your normal vaccine, your usual vaccine. And those videos, of course, they have the videos, but they keep being pulled down. So if you do want to hear for yourself what these women are saying, they have better know-how than me. But what they are saying is very much plausible, when you hear and you apply also your wisdom through what you hear, you can see that what these women are concerned about is legitimate. And the fact that these things are being suppressed, it actually makes you even more careful, not more careful, no, the word is not coming. It makes you more suspicious is the word. It makes you more suspicious when you see that the information is not being disseminated. It's not being allowed to be disseminated. It's like keep everybody ignorant. The Bible says, my people perish because of lack of knowledge. So we need to be well informed. We need to understand the new technologies that are being rolled out. We need to check it out. I have been checking it out. You don't just take someone's word for what they are saying. You go and check it out. So I was looking at the proposed vaccines, and for sure, I saw that I have read about it, and some people were saying it's transgenic, and if you do your research, you will find that. they have the potential to genetically modify us as human beings. Because once you have you hear of gene editing, that means your genes are being changed. Once you hear of a transgene, you are introducing some foreign matter into your genome. So it's something to look into for people. And do your research. Look for these videos. If you want me to send you, you can message me and I will send them to you so that you listen and make your own evaluation. Yeah, this information is being suppressed, so we should disseminate it to as many people as will listen. The Bible says, he who has an ear, let him hear. So it's up to the individual to decide for themselves how they want, what they want. God bless you. This is becoming too long. I'll end here.